everyone. My name is Jaylene Marcos, and welcome to X Me Out. Now, in this game, teams will answer questions to place their marker on our tic-tac-toe board. So if you play tic-tac-toe, this is the game. Okay, let's just jump and meet the teams right away. Let's meet the teams. Playing for the X team, we have Isabelle McCalla, who, you know, she promises to bring the competition. Isabelle, hello? Hello, please say words to the people.
Words, words, words. I am
okay, enough.
Okay, yeah, that's fair.
No, how are you?
I'm good, how are you doing?
I'm great. I'm X-ing people out here, so.
Well, I'm ready to bring the X factor, if you know what I mean.
So, okay.
To a brief introduction, my name is Isabelle McCalla. I am an actor, currently unemployed or fun employed, and I like long walks on the beach.
Great, stop bragging. Okay, great. Awesome. And Isabelle's partner is Ian Corsi, and it says here that you started your own business. Now tell us about that, Ian.
Well, over quarantine, this kind of started off as a joke, but a few of my friends and I decided that we wanted to create a music theater camp for younger kids to have a creative outlet during quarantine since all their shows got canceled. So we grew up doing these music theater intensives, so we kind of knew the format and like what worked and what didn't. So the three of us founded a company and we did three or four sessions, and it was a huge hit and it was so much fun. And we got to connect with all these kids and, you know, teach them how to sing and act and dance. And it was really amazing.
Oh, that's incredible. So you're like a producer now, are you?
I guess so.
So where can I send my stuff? Anyway, yeah, I'll send it later. I'll just send it. But thank you, Ian. Good to have you here. Yes, business entrepreneur. So that is our Team X. Now let's meet your opponents. Just to let you know about them, they brought fierce gaming skills across the country as Mike TV. And let's see if he brought these to the show. It's Daniel Quadrino. Hello.
Hi. Thank you for having me. This is so fun.
Yes. Tell us your social security number. And
yes. I'm Danny. And during quarantine, I've just been taking it day by day and just trying to stay positive. So this is amazing. I'm so happy to be here.
Great. Well, and we have your partner, Melissa Clark. Hello. Tell us about yourself. And we know that you are a former pageant queen.
Yes. I'm Melissa. I'm quarantining from Pittsburgh, PA. And yes, I used to compete in pageants, started late compared to most. I know people think of like toddlers and tiaras, but I started when I was like 12 and got into it.
Late start.
Late in the game.
I know. I understand. I'm starting out soon. We'll get there.
Beautiful.
Well, thank you. We've got Team X and Team O. Now, here's how the game works. Because we know tic-tac-toe, but this is how we'll be playing it here at X Me Out. So the goal of the game is to complete a line of X or O markers on the tic-tac-toe board. And each of the nine spaces on the board is with a certain trivia category. Contestants will alternate choosing a category and answering a question in that category. If they are correct, they earn an X or O in that square. If they are incorrect, the other team will get a chance to steal. And just so you know, the game will be played in rounds, and there will be three of them. The first round will be Isabelle versus Melissa. Round two, Daniel versus Ian. And round three, both X team members versus both O team members. So anyone got any questions, comments, recipes that you'd like to share before we start? No? Okay. Well, let's begin the first round. Your categories are Aladdin, Sylvia, Young Frankenstein, Ghost, Applause, 925, Diner, Kinky Boots, and Titanic. Okay, Isabelle.
Okay. I am going to go with, I feel like I want to get that center spot. Should I go for it right away? I'm going to go for it. Applause. Let's go. Ooh. Applause. We're going to try.
Oh,
for it.
Okay. 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 Applause. Mm. The category is Tony Awards. Name two of the three women who have won a Tony for their portrayal of Mama Rose.
All right. Well, I know the most recent Patti LuPone won. So it's got to be Mama Patti. Mama, I know her. I'm a daughter. A daughter Patty. And I feel like the original Ethel Merman won the Tony, but I could be wrong. So I'm gonna just go with Ethel Merman, Patti LuPone, final answer.
Okay. So your final answer. That's your final answer?
Yes.
Sorry. That was incorrect.
No!
Yes. Oh, God. I love the drama. I love the drama. Everyone wants to be on zero. Okay.
I'm so sorry.
Okay. So Team O, name two of the three women who have won a Tony for their portrayal of Mama Rose.
See, the way I'm more familiar with the celebs who have come through to play Mama Rose as opposed to the Tony winners. I'm not even going to hold you. I'm not even going to hold you, Jaylene. I don't know this one. I don't know this one.
Okay. So nobody got that. And so I am going to reveal the answers. So yes, Mama LuPone, also known as Patti LuPone. Tyne Daly, everybody. Tyne Daly, Mama. And then we have Angela Lansbury. Yes. Okay. Okay. So no one got that. So, Melissa, you've got control of the board. What would you like? What square would you like?
I'm going to stick with what's familiar here. Let's go with Aladdin.
Ooh, okay, Aladdin. And the category is Disney. What animal was the Sheriff of Nottingham in Robin Hood?
Sheriff of Naughty who?
Think it out loud. Just the more you think out loud, the better it'll help us all.
Maybe it'll come to me the more I say it. The Sheriff of Nottingham. And Robin Hood, is that?
In Robin Hood, yes. In Robin Hood. What animal? Think of the animal.
I don't want to just say a wild animal.
No animal will be hurt. No, and every animal should have a right to play this role. So whatever you say is the right answer. Any animal can play this right now. There is a hamster waiting in the wings to play this.
A wolf?
Yes, that is correct.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Wow. Yes. Wow. I love that. You see how you just worked it out? You worked it out. That's how we need to do it. So that's 5 points for the O's. Okay, so let's continue. Isabel, what square would you like to try?
Oh gosh, hopefully I do better this time, Ian. I am gonna go with, what do I not want her to get? Let's go ghost.
So ghost, and the category is paranormal. This German word translates in English to noisy ghost.
We are going to say, okay, well, the Latin root of what was the
love
Latin?
These two people, they think they teach the children now.
No.
They'll teach the children.
Hold up. I already forgot. Noisy ghost. Okay. Well, I know that we say sprechen Sie Deutsch. For speak German. So I'm going to say if it's a noisy ghost, it's going to speak. So I'm going to say, sprechen Sie Geuchti.
Sounds like a tasty dish that you have with hollandaise sauce. No. I'm going to say no. No. So that is incorrect. Melissa, do you have the answer? Or the German word that translate in English.
closest thing I've been to anything German related is like Hofbräuhaus, y'all. So no, I do not. I cannot
just even no.
Air. Just no.
Just the answer is no. Not even none.
I'm not even gonna butcher the culture right now.
Okay, well, the answer is Poltergeist. Okay, we're gonna now go back to Melissa. Okay, pick a square.
Okay, let's go with kinky boots.
Kinky boots, and the category is fashion. This animal, known for its grace, was part of the Gloria Vanderbilt jeans logo.
Known for its grace.
Yeah.
Graceful animals. Grace. I'm thinking swan. I'm thinking of other graceful animals. I'm gonna stick with swan. First that comes to mind.
Okay. Well, it is swan. I love how, yes, oh, it's just, oh, listen, I just love it. Oh, okay, great. Team O, you've got 5 points, and now you're up to 10 points. Izzy, or Isabelle.
Yeah.
Okay, pick a square.
Let's go with applause.
Okay, applause, which is Tony Awards. Okay, name two of the Tony Award winning best musicals where only one person single-handedly wrote the book, music, and lyrics.
I got one, The Music Man. And no, because it beat out West Side Story, Meredith Willson wrote book, music, lyrics. That's one. Oh God. Oh, my head of department would be so ashamed at me right now. I'm gonna get this, I swear.
Sing it out.
What best musicals? Okay, we had Billy Elliot, definitely wasn't. Classics, Cabaret was not written. The book was written by somebody different. Gypsy. Gypsy was, no, different. Wait, no, different, because Leonard Bernstein, Stephen Sondheim. Oh my God, what other, I need to think. Composers and lyricists and playwrights. I want to say James Lapine doesn't do music. Book of Mormon. No, because that's Kristin Lopez, and no, that's not it, because they didn't write the book. Shit. Oh, fuck me sideways on a biscuit. It's God, excuse my language. What are the classics? Oh, Oscar Hammerstein wrote, no, but he didn't do the music. God damn it. Who did music and lyrics? McCalla. Work through your musical history, not musical theater history.
Your knowledge is really impressive, though. Oh, you do have a lot of knowledge.
Wait, is it Dear Evan Hansen? Baskin Paul? Did they write the book, too? I don't know if they wrote the book. It's not, they didn't write the book. Ian saying, he's shaking his head, they didn't write the book. God damn it! What is it? Oh, my. Am I going to be really mad when I find this out? I'm going to be really mad, aren't I? I'm going to be really mad. It's going to be super obvious. It's not a Disney thing. It's not an Alan Menken thing. I'm so sorry. You're going to have to like super cut this, and it's just going to be bits of me completely falling apart. Avenue Q. Who did Avenue Q? No. Color Purple. No. Hamilton. Final answer. Hamilton and Music Man. Hamilton and Music Man. Final answer.
You are correct. We worked through it. We all worked through it. We all had a pizza. We delivered the pizza. Yes. Okay, so you got that X in the center square, bringing up your team to 5 points. You're doing well. You're back on the board. So let's go to Melissa. Okay. What square do you want?
All right. Let's see here. Let's try 9 to 5. Let's see what's there.
9 to 5. The category is working class. So, the Lusty Lady became the world's first union-controlled strip club. What U.S. city did the Lusty Lady call home?
Lusty Lady. can you repeat it, please?
You just want me to say lusty lady.
I do. I just like the alliteration.
Lusty lady. Okay. The lusty lady became the world's first union-controlled strip club. What U.S. city did the lusty lady call home? What city was lusty lady?
Where would a strip club like be established? I feel like down south somewhere, you know? Maybe Mississippi? I'm just guessing. It's a guess. Mississippi, final answer.
Final answer? Incorrect.
All right, thank you.
Lusty lady didn't go there. I don't know her travels, but that was not home. That was not home for her. Okay, Isabel.
You said
do you know the U.S. city?
Unionized strip club?
Yes, union controlled.
Okay.
15-minute call? Okay. You know, it was just all.
Right. We like it. Okay, lusty lady. With a
union. Your understudy's on. Okay. Yeah, union controlled strip club.
I am going to go with Las Vegas. Lusty lady. Las Vegas. Union controlled.
Incorrect. Sorry. Sorry.
Sorry, Ian.
I know. Okay. The answer is San Francisco. But all your places were, yeah, I'm sure there's a lusty lady there as well. I'm sure there are lusty ladies everywhere now. But no.
Right here.
Okay. Okay. Yep. Okay. You are not union controlled. Okay. So let us continue with Isabel. Pick a square.
Hello. I'm going to go back to diner because I love food. Oh.
Okay. Here we go. What is the French culinary term for a dish that has been covered in breadcrumbs or grated cheese, then browned?
Mm. Oh, au gratin. A-U-G-R-A-T-I-N. Au gratin.
Is that your answer? Yeah! Okay, well, that is correct. Au gratin. Oui, oui, oui. Yeah!
Je parle français. Merci beaucoup.
Oui, je parle français aussi. So both teams are at 10. So we got 10 and 10. Very nice work. Melissa.
All right. Let's see. I'm going to go for Young Frankenstein again.
What does the acronym DNA stand for? Is child your answer?
It might have to be. No. This is a shame, y'all. My mother is a pediatrician. double nucleus? That don't make sense because nothing can have two nucleuses. The cell only got one. Really taking me back, y'all, to biology. Ninth grade. Okay. Double nucleus.
Yeah.
I don't know, y'all. I don't know the A. I don't know the A. I'm so sorry.
Yes.
I'll be searching for it.
Okay. No, thank you. No is not correct. Isabel.
Okay, I'm pretty sure I have it, but I'm worried that I'm gonna join too, but I'm gonna go with my gut anyway. And my gut says deoxyribonucleic acid. Or is it just deoxynucleic acid? I think it's deoxyribonucleic acid. Final answer.
Yes, Miss. Yes!
Yes!
I am so glad you said it so I didn't have to. I was gonna break it up, but that is correct, is the acid. We're looking for that acid. So Team X won with 20 points, and you got 10. You got 10. And you got that swan, you got that wolf. Very memorable. Okay, so let us now, we're going to go to a commercial, and then we'll be back. And welcome back for round two for X Me Out. For the X team, we have Ian. Woo! And Daniel O team. Okay, the categories are Sunday in the Park, Hands on a Hard Body, Bye Bye Birdie, Damn Yankees, Wonderful Town, The Music Man, Anything Goes, Waitress, Escape to Margaritaville. Daniel, which square would you like to try first?
I'm going to go with Escape to Margaritaville. Go with what you know.
Escape. Okay, go with what you know. Okay, Escape to Margaritaville. Go with what you know. You're following your gut. And the category for that is booze. Did we get it correct? Okay, so booze. At the turn of the 20th century, this holiday cocktail was used to help patients recover from smallpox.
Cough syrup, Robitussin.
Tasty cocktails. Yeah. Are a Robitussin on the rocks, please?
Can I get a NyQuil on the rocks, please?
That's just...
Yeah, that is bad. I feel like something isn't like vodka numbing. Am I wrong? Is that no? I
it can numb your feelings.
Yeah, that maybe. I'm gonna give you just whiskey.
A whiskey okay.
cocktail.
Just a whiskey cocktail. Incorrect. You know. But that's what you have on a holiday, not Robitussin. If you said Robitussin, then we'd have a problem. But you said whiskey. It's not the correct answer for this one. So, Ian, do you have the answer for this holiday cocktail that was used for patients?
Okay. I'm in college, so I don't drink at all. A cocktail? I don't even know how to make a cocktail. I'm going to say... You know what? No, I had a feel. I'm going to go Bloody Mary. I don't know why. I'm just having a feeling of Bloody Mary. Final answer.
Final answer, Bloody Mary. Incorrect.
Yeah, I thought so.
But I do like the idea of Merry Christmas. Can I get a Bloody? You know, it's just very, I didn't even it is think a little controversial. But, you know, I do love it. I do love it. That is incorrect. The correct answer is eggnog.
Oh,
yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Right. So, you know, that's what they did. Whether or not it worked or not, who knows? You know, but we all try things. So, Ian, let us have, you can now choose a square.
Okay. I'm trying to think of like what the subjects would be for each square. So I'm going to go with Music Man.
The category is male musicians.
Oh,
okay, here we go. This musician danced with a pre-famed Courtney Cox in his Dancing in the Dark music video.
Okay, so not many musicians dance, right? That's what I'm thinking. That's my thought process. The one person that pops in my head is Michael Jackson. I don't know if he has a song called Dancing in the Dark. That doesn't ring a bell for one of his songs. The two like dance musicians I know, Michael Jackson, maybe like Justin Timberlake, maybe like, you know, I'm going to go with Michael Jackson. I'm going with Michael Jackson.
Incorrect. Yeah. Sorry. You tried. Daniel, do you?
Michael Jackson was a thought process of mine. And then Justin Timberlake was another thought process of mine.
I love how the top, you are... Just mind melding, but
I'm just still thinking here. I think okay, so Courtney Cox is not well. She's I wouldn't say that she probably didn't dance with like anybody recently. Not because she's old, just because she just probably hasn't. And I'm also gonna use the term dancing as a loosely based term of dancing because like she's not doing like pirouettes. Could you imagine? And then I thought Lady Gaga, but she's not a male. Because Dancing in the Dark, the only person I know that has Dancing in the Dark is the Bruce Springsteen.
Is that your answer?
Yes, Bruce Springsteen is my answer.
That is correct.
Yes! I don't know how I did that.
Okay, my face hurts. Yes, correct. Yes, the O's have gotten 5 points and got the Music Man square. Very nice, very nice. Daniel.
The middle.
So Wonderful Town, this is the center square, and this is where you will be giving, this is a two-parter here for that center square. So the category is famous cities. According to Around the World in 80 Days, what are two of the 9 cities marked as stops along the route?
Oh my God. Okay, cities like Around the World in 80 Days. Like, we gotta hit the highlights. Okay. Isn't that a musical? I wish I knew the musical, because maybe there'd be a song about it. Okay. Okay, cities. So I'm gonna say London, because that sounds cool. And I'm also gonna say New York. I don't know. 2 of the 9. Maybe it's right.
That is correct.
Whoa! Okay.
London and New York are one of the cities. So the O's, yay, they have now 10 points. Okay.
Glad to see you.
This is gonna be so embarrassing if he sweeps me like this. Okay. I'm gonna go with Damn Yankees, because that seems like a choice.
We gotta go for the block here. We gotta go for the block. I don't wanna coach you, but we're going for the block here. So Damn Yankees category is baseball. Here we go, Ian. Here's your question. Who holds the record for the most home runs in a single Major League Baseball season?
Okay. Oh my gosh. So it was Babe Ruth, and he got... Oh, what's his name? I used to play baseball for like 10 years, and if I miss this, it's going to be so embarrassing. Oh, what is his name? He was on the Blue Jays, right? He was on the Blue Jays. He beat Babe Ruth. Is it Reggie Jackson? I'm trying to think of the YouTube clip that I watched and see. Reggie Jackson. It's not Barry Bonds. Is it Barry Bonds? Oh. It's either Barry Bonds or Reggie Jackson. I think it's Barry Bonds. I think it's Barry Bonds. I'm going with Barry Bonds.
That is correct.
Oh my God.
Barry Bonds. Barry Bonds. Very nice, so Ian. Scary. You got the block.
Wow, nice job.
Five points. Nice job. Whoo. Okay. Daniel, put that O on the board. What square do you want? Here, we got a block.
Also, Billy Bonds. I'm like, Billy Bonds over here. Come on. I'll just send some such like
Billy Bonds. It's actually Barry Bonds. But yeah. I got him. Billy Bonds. Billy Elliot. Come on. We got Billy Ed up on the back.
Sports ball. All right. What is the top right? I'm sorry, I'm blind.
Bye bye, birdie.
Oh, well, I guess I'll have to do that one.
Okay, so the category is birds. So here we go. Which bird has eyes that are larger than its brain?
Okay, a lot of birds have tiny brains, from what you can see, I guess. And so
on the outside, right.
Larger eyes than their brain. Owls have really big eyes. But that's like, there's so many birds. Who are you? I'm gonna go with an owl. I'm just gonna, strong and wrong.
That is strong. That is incorrect.
Yeah, okay.
Ian, do you know which bird has eyes that are larger than its brain?
My first thought was owl. But an ostrich is a bird, right? I'm going to go with ostrich, because they have really, really small heads. An ostrich? Ostrich. I'm going to go with ostrich.
Okay. Correct?
Oh!
Yes! What? Yes! Nice! You're on a roll, Barry Bonds. You got the ostrich, Ian. You got the X. The X is going on that top corner. Okay. Very nice. And 5 points there. So, Ian, let's find another square.
All right. I think Sunday in the Park with George is going to be art, right? Yeah, I'm going to go just to block them if they want to go die. Sunday in the Park with George.
Okay. Art. There it is. Okay, it is art is the category. Here we go. American Gothic, a 1930 portrait depicting a farmer and his daughter in front of their house, was painted by which artist?
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, me too. Oh, gosh. I thought this was going to be a Music Man, because when I did Music Man, that picture with that painting was in it for some reason. I don't know if that's in the actual show or that's just... That's the one with the farmer and the pitchfork and then the wife. It's...
Yes, depicting a farmer and his daughter in front of their house.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, because, okay, we talked about this when we did the show. Okay.
Something. Wait, he's just listing his resume right now.
Something Wood. It's James Wood. No, that's not it. His last name's Wood, or her name. Okay. Grant Wood. Final answer, Grant Wood.
That is correct.
Let's go.
Yes, Ian.
Oh, my
Yay.
God.
Plus 5 points, so your total is 15 points. You are learning things in school. I tell you, I should have gone to school. I really should have gone past the conservatory, but I didn't. But I got to where I am, and I'm fine. So, Daniel, it is back to you now. Pick a square.
I have to block them, so.
Yes.
Whatever that says.
That is anything goes.
Work.
Anything goes. And this is grab bag. This is grab
Perfect.
Bag in the category.
Perfect.
This fictional mariner was said to have gone on 7 voyages across the seas of Africa and Asia. No, I don't mean the comedian from A Different World.
Come on, grab bag. I have absolutely no clue. Are we surprised? I honestly have. This fictional mariner.
Just remember, this anything goes. Anything goes. So you could.
Reno Sweeney is my answer.
In your head, it is correct, but it is incorrect here for the answer. Ian, can you?
They did not teach us this at school, so I have absolutely no idea. Just because you said comedian, I'm just going to say Seinfeld. I don't know. I have no idea.
Incorrect. But the answer is Sinbad. Right? We did our best. Okay. So no one got that corner there. And we have, actually, Ian, you are next. Pick a square.
I'll go with anything goes.
Okay. Anything goes. Here is your question, Ian. What process is used to make cow's milk suitable for humans to drink?
I was going to say lactation, but that does not sound right.
I can't even hide my face.
It's a solid
You're a musical theater, you musical theater major, right?
Correct. Okay. I assume that there's lots of bacteria in the cow milk when it comes out of the cow. So they have to get that out of the milk. But I don't know how they do that. Oh my gosh. Okay. I may have heard this when I was learning how to churn butter because I went to this really old house.
And I kind of need to know more about that.
They had this old butter maker and you got to churn it. It was something with a pasture. You're freaking out. Pasteurize. Is that right? Is the right direction? They. I don't even know what. Pasteurization. Pasteurization. Pasteurize. Final answer.
That is correct.
Oh!
Yes, Ian.
Yes.
5 points. A total of 25 points. And that X goes on right there on that anything goes pasteurization.
You won.
Won.
You won the round.
Woo!
Yes. X wins that round. And we're going to go to a commercial and we'll be right back.
Thanks for tuning in today. This IG Live Jazz Class. I'm David. So happy you're here. So excited to dance with you guys. Let's get going. All right, here we go.
I've come to take you there, show you how to care. Just be aware that you'll have to share. I want your love, I want it tonight. I'm taking your heart, so don't you fight.
Thank you so much. See you next week.
So welcome back. So the X's have 45 points and the O's have 25 points. And now we're going to do the final round where the teams will be working together. And if you thought their inner monologue was already interesting, I can only imagine the dialogue right now. You see, these are going to be published scenes now. It's incredible. There's going to be a lot of scenes. Here we go. Let's go for the final round. So we have Isabelle and Ian teaming up for the X's, and Daniel and Melissa will be for the O's. And the categories are going to be from the previous two rounds. So we have Escape to Margaritaville, Diner, Sunday in the Park, Young Frankenstein, Tootsie, Sylvia, Titanic, Aladdin, The Music Man. Okay, so now that the team O has the least amount of points, we'll have you go first. Which square would you like to try first?
I'm leaning towards Aladdin just because Disney seems safe, and I don't know about you, but that's where I'm.
Let's put it safe, Daniel.
All right, we'll start out small. We'll take some chances, but let's start with Aladdin.
Okay, Aladdin, as we know, it is Disney. So your question is, what was Walt Disney's original name for Mickey Mouse before his wife convinced him to change it?
Convinced.
I was hoping for like a good old, like, what is this, a Disney classic? But no. What's... The black and white is Steamboat Willie.
Yeah, I should have watched that.
You know, it's like, you know that from the old ride? Yeah, the whistle of the thing. And I feel like, that was really like one of the earlier things that.
Let's see. I'll leave it up to me, and I was about to be like, Walter.
But... Walter Disney.
Not it.
Walter Mouse. Walter Mouse.
Probably something like not even close to Walt.
I don't know, maybe Steamboat Willie, but also that could be if we can't think of anything else. But I'm kind of drawn to that. Mickey the Rat. No, I'm just kidding.
This is Mickey's original name, not Walt's, right?
Yes, yeah.
Okay.
Yes, Walt Disney's original name for Mickey Mouse before his wife said, "You are not calling him that."
Oh.
I can't quote her if she said that. She probably did, really?
I think should we just Got it.
I don't know.
Should we just go with, you know, I mean, if we're going to lose, let's lose big. Let's go with Steamboat Willie. Should we try that?
Sure.
Strong choice. Go with a strong choice.
Steamboat Willie.
Okay, that is incorrect. Incorrect. But I get it. Okay. Perfect. So let us go to the other. We got the X's. Isabelle, do you got it?
I think.
What are you thinking?
I have a little anecdote for this one too.
When you were churning butter with the.
No, one of my best friends wants to work at Disney. So he's like crazy about all these Disney facts.
Oh, amazing.
What were you thinking?
Go for it. I know it's an old timey name. So I want you to tell me what it is. We can talk it out.
Okay.
So what are you thinking it is?
It's something more timer.
Mortimer.
Okay. Mortimer.
I think it's Mortimer. Yeah.
Final answer.
Do you agree? Final answer? Yeah. Final answer. Mortimer.
That is correct.
I don't even know what that means.
Yes, the X's. Yay! You've got 5 points, and you have an X right there on the Aladdin. So, Mortimer, boom, 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 Mortimer.
Why do I feel like all of Ian's answers is like Slumdog Millionaire? Like he has a life story for everything.
Okay, so let us go to Isabelle and Ian. You pick a square.
Should we go for the big center? Just because.
Yeah. Let's go. Is that Tootsie? Right.
Yeah, it's Tootsie. Assuming it's candy or something.
It is candy. Mm-hmm. You don't get any points for that, but good. You got Tootsie. Okay, so candy is the category for that center square. Name 2 of the original 8 flavors of Jelly Belly jelly beans.
I feel like there's got to be classics, right? So like
like
a sour apple or like a lemon.
Fruity Tootie. That sounds fruity like.
Weren't they just like named after actual things though? Like fruits, grapes.
I keep thinking of like the Harry Potter ones.
I know. I'm gonna be like, earwax. I feel like we should. Oh, licorice. Do you think licorice was one of them?
Yeah, that seems like something they would have when they were making it. Strawberry. Do you think lemon?
I do. I mean, there were yellow ones, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Or maybe not. Maybe I'm wrong. I was wrong with Ethel Merman, so I could be wrong with this. Bubblegum? Or is that a bit? That feels advanced.
I think that's a little advanced. Grape? Oh. I think grape. That sounds safe.
Grape feels good.
Then strawberry? Grape and strawberry? Or licorice? Grape and licorice?
Licorice, what color would licorice be? Would licorice be black? One of the original 8? That actually kind of makes sense. If it was like every color of the rainbow and then black. Yeah, why don't we do that? Grape and licorice?
Okay. Grape and licorice.
Grape and licorice, final answer.
Correct.
Oh, yes.
X's, you've got another 5 on the board and a total of 10 points.
Ooh.
Nice job there. Great. So the O's, Daniel and Lissy, where would you like to, what square would you like?
We got a block.
Got a block. It is diner food. Okay. Here we go. What ingredient is added to white sugar to make brown sugar?
Is it like a nutmeg or is it like cinnamon? Well, at least we're entertaining. Okay. What do they add to sugar?
What do they make to
brown it? Oh, is it, would it be like vanilla extract to make it a little brown?
Would that color it? Would that make it white?
Maybe it's going like white to brown sugar.
Oh, is it white to brown or brown to white?
Yeah, right? White to brown.
What ingredient is added to white sugar to make brown sugar?
To make brown sugar, so to make it brown, they ain't put no cocoa in there. Flavor it. Maybe like, what's the sticky stuff? Like the sticky,
That not that makes.
Oh, I know what you're saying.
Agave,
like blue agave.
Not agave, but like. Oh,
that's some rich brown sugar. Right,
that's expensive. What about molasses? How about molasses?
Oh, that's good. Yeah. I'm here for that.
You think it's maybe?
No, I think that makes stuff brown.
Agave. What color is agave? Agave is like
clear. Well, I guess you can get like there's like the clear one and the yeah. Let's go with molasses. I'm here for this.
Okay. All right.
I wish we could hold hands and then shout together when we were right or wrong.
Yeah, we're all picturing that exactly. If we were all together, we know this moment would happen.
Yeah.
Okay, let's do it.
Yes, pinkies, just pinkies.
Yeah.
So your final answer, O's, is what is your answer?
Melissa, go for it. You
got molasses. Let's go. Yeah. Molasses. Is that a copy?
That is correct.
Yes.
That is correct. Yes, you have a total of 5, and the O's have 5, and you are blocked. Okay,
I'm so proud
we're
of you.
we're still in this round, and I love that agave comes in, and but no. Oh, the kids. The kids these days. Okay. Isabel, Ian.
Yeah.
Find a square.
I'm kind of feeling Titanic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, that's here's my the favorite thing, though.
Movie. Yeah.
I love Titanic. Mm-hmm. But if we go there, then they have an option to... Actually, no. Yeah, we can go to Titanic. Let's do Titanic. Okay. Your favorite musical. Let's do it.
Titanic. The category is blockbusters. Okay, which actor that once played James Bond previously competed in the Mr. Universe bodybuilding competition?
Oh my God! Wait, I think oh fudge. Okay, the Bonds. We have Sean Connery. We have what's his face? Oh God, it's Pierce Brosnan.
I automatically thought Arnold Schwarzenegger, but he did not.
But he didn't do it.
Yeah.
Who was the last guy? I was about to say the British dude, and they're all British. he's married to Rachel Weisz. Oh, the guy, Knives Out guy. What other Bonds are there besides Sean Connery and
Daniel Craig?
Daniel Craig. Yes, that's his name. I feel like he seems like more of a bodybuilder than Sean. It's definitely not Pierce Brosnan. Like for sure not Pierce Brosnan. But Sean Connery, like maybe he was. Like I feel like bodybuilding back in the day was not like bodybuilding now. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like it's not a swole bra.
I'm kind of feeling Daniel Craig.
I feel like he's like broader.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah. And he has that confidence that a bodybuilder would have.
Yeah. And they're probably looking at him and like, you could fuck some shit up.
Exactly.
So maybe, should we say Daniel Craig final
let's
answer?
Let's say Daniel Craig.
Incorrect.
Damn it.
What?
Daniel and Melissa, do you have the answer for which actor that once played James Bond previously competed in the Mr. Universe bodybuilding competition?
Maybe
she can sing too, everybody.
Oh. He's tried it. I don't know which one and which one before that, so because I never kept up with like, the early 007 ones.
I mean, we could just pass because then it would just be a wash, but
okay, we'll pass,
or we could try.
I have no clue. We're going to pass. Sorry. Yeah, sorry.
You're going to truly pass. Okay. The correct answer is Sean Connery.
Oh.
No.
Right.
Should have gone with your answer. We should have gone with
it. Okay.
Now we know. We've learned something.
You've learned.
We've learned.
Move on.
Yeah.
We're going to move on to the O's. Daniel and Melissa find a square. And let us try to get that win.
Okay, let's go. Should we do Escape to Margaritaville or oh God, or Sunday in the Park with George's art? I took art harsh art.
art history.
Artwork.
Enough art history. Freshman. But I don't know if I remember anything. I know more about drinking, I feel like, than I do art. What about you?
Robitussin. We're all just going to go back to Robitussin.
Let's do Margaritaville.
Okay.
Okay, for Margaritaville booze. Okay, here's your question, my O's. What popular soda beverage was originally developed as a mixer for whiskey? Oh, we're bringing it back to the whiskey. This is Daniel. This is all you. So what was the popular soda beverage that was originally developed as a mixer for whiskey?
What was it? Coke?
That was my first thought, but it also, like, before Coke, I feel like, was Tab, but I don't know if you would put Tab in whiskey.
I'm not familiar with Tab. But I trust you.
To mix with Mixie. I had two sips of a beer and I'm gone.
what would they mix with?
Whiskey but I feel like whiskey and Coke, or whiskey and ginger ale, or whiskey. I'm just listing my whiskey preferences now.
Whiskey. What kind of soda goes with it? It isn't even a soda that we have now that we would even like be familiar with.
It could be, but I also don't know. That's why I said Tab, but I don't think they mix Tab in.
What popular soda beverage was originally developed as a mixer for whiskey?
So popular.
I think it could be Coca-Cola. Okay. Or it could be, no, but they're, but like, because, well, I guess, you, yeah, let's, yeah, Coca-Cola,
maybe?
Coca-Cola. Solid. So Coca-Cola is your answer?
Yes.
Sorry, that is not the answer.
Okay.
You know,
Isabel, Ian, do we have a popular soda beverage that you think?
I am also thinking ginger ale, because mules.
I'm thinking either that or Mountain Dew.
Mountain Dew with whiskey?
Yeah.
You drink that?
I really hope you don't drink that.
Because it's such a strong flavor. And it kind of overpowers the whiskey.
I mean, I guess. But I don't know. I don't know when. I mean, whiskey's been around for forever. Right. You know that. And the it's not Coke. I mean, it could be Dr. Pepper. Or like, my instinct is ginger ale because of Kentucky Mules and Moscow Mules. So like there are cocktails with ginger ale and those drinks and whiskey. That's why I'm think my instinct is to go more with ginger ale. Cause I can't really think of any other cocktails that go with it except for Coke and ginger ale. So I feel like it's ginger ale, unless it was intended and it was a complete flop, whatever soda beverage it was. Like root beer or something, but root beer is just pure deliciousness on its own. You seem hesitant to go with ginger ale.
I do.
Why? Talk me through it.
I don't know why. Well, they're both Mountain Dew and ginger ale are very similar, right? They're very similar.
Mountain Dew would be shit with whiskey.
Okay, let's go with ginger ale.
Okay. Ginger ale, final answer.
That is not correct.
Oh, is it? If it's Mountain Dew, I feel so bad.
No, the answer is Mountain Dew.
Oh my gosh.
Are you serious?
It's Mountain Dew.
Are you actually serious right now?
If anyone ordered that right now, I really would be like, what? But
I'm so sorry. I am so sorry.
No, you chose the logical answer.
Yeah, okay, I guess, sense.
But Ian
I
drinks.
I guess we canceled each other out.
Mountain Dew and whiskey, so.
You know, you nixed my Sean Connery, I nixed your Mountain Dew.
We even it out.
Is, next time we hang out, we're trying that.
Okay, actually, we're back with Isabel and Ian, too.
Correct. Great.
Find a box.
Stick with Escape to Margaritaville, or do you want to go to Sunday in the Park with George or Titanic or Music Man? We have a way to win in four quarters.
I think we were pretty close on Blockbuster. I think that's a broad category. That's pretty easy to get something good.
Yeah.
Should we try?
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
Yeah, let's do it again.
Okay. Titanic, Blockbusters. Okay. The song Eye of the Tiger by the band Survivor was the theme song for what movie released in 1982?
Rocky.
Rocky.
Dan, 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 dan. Dun-ka-dun. Dan, dan, dan.
Dun.
Rocky's final answer.
No.
What?
What?
What? Are you kidding?
I quit.
What?
Everything I know is a lie.
Daniel and Melissa, do you have an answer for the song Eye of the Tiger by the band Survivor was the theme song for what movie released in 1982?
Okay. What? I thought that I
definitely thought it was Rocky, so I'm
same. Oh, could it be like what other movies would be like have that song in it? I feel like
I literally just watched Karate Kid the other
time. I was about to say that, so that's wrong. Okay.
Action 80, like yeah. Sports related.
Is it a movie about a tiger?
RoboCop.
Yeah. Wally. No, I'm just kidding. Truly no clue, Melissa. I really thought it was Rocky. Like, that's just so iconic that I just thought that was what it was. I think we're gonna pass again.
Okay, so that is not a correct answer. The correct answer is Rocky 3.
Absolutely not.
No. That is cruel.
That was a good one. We all learned a lesson today. We all learned, right? Okay. So we're back with Melissa O's and Daniel. Find a square.
You want to try Sunday in the Park? See what we got.
Yeah, let's see if we see George. Come on, let's do it.
Okay. Sunday in the Park with George. Art. Here is... for our wonderful Daniel, art historian, who painted a late 15th century mural known as the Last Supper?
I left my Roman Catholic roots behind me, so I got this. Okay. Is it Michelangelo?
That was the first that came to mind, but I feel like he's a little too ancient.
Or like... Batiste. Okay, so it's 15th century, you said, right?
Correct.
15th okay, so that's century pretty mural. Damn old. So that's like pretty damn old. Okay, so we should say something.
At this point,
I feel like we're confronting somebody. We should tell them something.
This is an art history intervention.
Art history. Yeah, we should tell them. We have to do it now. Maybe I don't know. I we could just try.
Michelangelo. I shot down Michelangelo so quick, but
I know. But I'm like, why not? Maybe.
Go for it.
Yeah, we're gonna try Michelangelo. We're gonna bless up, and it's yeah.
Bless up. It's incorrect. It's incorrect. But we blessed up. You know what? You left your roots, honey.
Yeah,
that's what happens.
Leonardo da Vinci.
Da Vinci. You know why I know that? Because of the Da Vinci Code.
My dad just watched it. I should have paid attention. I should have sat down and watched it.
That is correct, X's. And and Isabel. Yes, a total of 15. Izzy and Ian, pick a square.
Comes back to Titanic. We got it.
Yeah, baby.
Okay.
Redemption.
Redemption. Here we go. In the Marvel Cinematic Universe, what is the name of Thor's home planet?
Ah, it's Asgard. He is an Asgardian. I just went through all of the... Wait, it's not Asgard? They're shaking their heads.
I think it is. It is Asgard.
It's Asgard.
Yeah.
It's Asgard.
Oh, that is correct, answer. That is correct. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
The correct answer is Lusty Lady. That is the home of... X, you won the final round with 25 points for that final round, and your final total is 70 points.
Woo!
Cover X!
Come on, go blue!
Go blue!
Go blue. And the O's? You used passes that don't even exist in this game. I mean, how
they're
incredible. Like, you added to this game and said, we're going to pass. And I said, that doesn't exist.
And we said, okay.
But that's how we play it here. I just take what I'm given and I, yes. But you blessed up. So congratulations, Team X, with 70 points. And you who are watching, if you want to be a contestant and have these inner monologues that everyone else has, there's no judgment at all the way you think of things. But if you want to join us in one of these games on Broadway Game Network, head to at Broadway Game Network on Instagram for more info. And remember to tune in every week for more games and your favorite Broadway celebrities for some more fun. So thank you, Isabel McCalla, Daniel Quadrino, Melissa Clark, and Ian Corsi for joining us today and enlightening us, reminding us that Mountain Dew is the drink of choice with your whiskey. I am Jaylene Marcos, and thank you for tuning in to X Me Out.